Good evening.
How are you? I'm Clare Apparently, and tonight I want to talk to you about drag queens. To start with, what is a drag queen? In homosexual terminology, a drag queen is a homosexual male who often or habitually dresses in female attire. A drag butch is a lesbian who often or habitually dresses in male attire. What motivates these homosexuals to do drag, you might ask? Well, we know that the principal opposition around which the gay world revolves is masculine versus feminine.
Yeah!
There are a number of ways of presenting this opposition through one's own person, where it becomes also an opposition of inside versus outside. For the great majority of homosexuals, the outer or social self is one of calculated respectability, while the inner or real self remains stigmatized. It should be readily apparent then why drag is such an effective symbol of both the outside-inside and the masculine-feminine oppositions. The effect of the drag system is to wrench the sex roles loose from that which supposedly determines them. Gay people know that the possession of one type of genital equipment by no means guarantees the naturally appropriate behavior.
Anthropologists say that sexual behavior is learned,
but the gay world, via drag, says that sexual behavior is an appearance that can be manipulated at will.
Drag symbolizes this assertion in a very complex way.
It is a double inversion that says appearance is an illusion. Drag first says my outside appearance is feminine, but my inside, that is my body, is masculine. At the same time, it symbolizes the opposite inversion. My appearance outside, that is my body, my gender, is masculine, but my essence inside is feminine. Camp signifies a relationship between things and homosexuality. In this sense, camp taste is synonymous with homosexual taste. Many ideas have been taken over by straights through the mass media, and it makes the idea no longer campy. For instance, a queen had once gotten the idea of growing plants in the backwater tank of her toilet. But the idea is no longer campy because now it is being advertised in family circle magazine. While camp is in the eye of the homosexual beholder, it is possible to discern strong themes in any particular campy thing or event. The three that seem most recurrent and characteristic to me are incongruity, theatricality, and humor. All three are intimately related to the homosexual situation. Incongruity is the subject matter of camp, theatricality is its style, and humor is its strategy. Creative camp depends on incongruous juxtapositions. One queen said that TV Guide had described a little Mexican horse statue as campy. He said that there was nothing campy at all about it, but if you put a nude cutout of Betty Davis on it, then it would be campy. Word deviation is at the core of the second property of camp, theatricality. If Greta Garbo playing women is drag, then homosexuals passing playing men, they too are in drag. This is the larger implication of drag and camp. In fact, gay people often use the word drag in this broader sense, even to include role-playing, which most people simply take for granted. Role-playing in school, at the office, at parties, and so on. But remember that role-playing is play. It is an act or show. The necessity to play at life, living role after superficial role, should not be cause for bitterness and despair. Most of the impersonations that homosexuals do are done with ease, grace, and especially humor. Camp is for fun. The aim of camp is to make an audience laugh. Camp humor is a system of laughing at one's incongruous position instead of crying. That is, the humor does not cover up, but rather, it transforms. One of the most confounding aspects of my interaction with the impersonators was their tendency to laugh at situations that to me were horrifying or tragic. I was amazed, for instance, when one impersonator described to me as very campy the scene in Whatever Happened to Baby Jane, in which Betty Davis served Joan Crawford a rat, or the scene in which Betty Davis makes her comeback in the parlor with the piano player. Homosexual Wit and Clown. His campy productions are a continuous creative strategy for dealing with the homosexual situation. By accepting his homosexuality and flaunting it, the camp undercuts the stigma and, in the process, defines a positive homosexual identity.
I thought that was an idea worth
spreading.